Do you want to
do it again? It just deteriorates. So my name is Dr. Rahim Salim. I'm a consultant gynecologist and I'm a subspecialist in reproductive medicine. I have a special interest in complex IVF cases, so women and men with complicated fertility problems who ordinarily wouldn't be treated in other clinics, I would normally look after. So fundamentally, IVF is a relatively simple process. To be able to describe the process, I think if we take a step back and think about what happens naturally every month for most women, so their brain makes a hormone called FSH, and the FSH tells the ovaries to make one egg, and then you ovulate that egg. What we would like to do in a conventional IVF cycle is help the woman make around 10 to 12 eggs, is what we're aiming for. I mean, IVF is associated with side effects, but the process is well tolerated. We've been doing it for a long time. Hormones are a little bit different, so you may feel a little bit different. And like any procedure, there's a small risk of infection and bleeding, but that is exceedingly rare. We worry about a condition called ovarian hyperstimulation, where women over-respond to the medications. But we keep a very close eye on you, and we're very accurately these days able to identify women who are at risk. So a good clinic should be monitoring you appropriately, and ovarian hyperstimulation should be exceedingly rare, if not almost entirely eliminated from good clinics. So egg freezing to preserve fertility is increasingly being done. Eggs freeze well. The technology for freezing eggs changed a few years ago. And the more eggs you freeze, the better your chances of success. I think we all remember our first success stories, and they're really good because that's really what we want. And that's all you ever seem to read about is successful stories. And as much as the success is important, the failures are important as well. What that means for women and their families. But actually, there is a second side to it, equally important, but slightly forgotten. On average, an IVF cycle has about a 30 to 35% chance of achieving a pregnancy. So for most women, they will need 2 to 3 cycles to fall pregnant. There is this recommendation from NICE, which is the national recommendation body for clinical treatment in the UK. And NICE recommends 3 cycles of IVF to be provided by the NHS. That number 3 is not picked out of thin air. It is actually the average number of cycles it takes for people to fall pregnant. So treatment add-ons are a controversial aspect of IVF treatment. They are increasingly popular, and many patients will read up about add-ons and their potential benefit before they come and see me, specifically because a lot of patients I see have had failed cycles elsewhere. And my view always has been that if you educate patients, if you actually tell them what the evidence tells you, I think the majority, usually by the end of the consultation, don't want to do it anymore. The problem with IVF is it has turned into an industry of hope. There's a lot of marketing of hope. Everybody seems to have a unique selling point of some description, which allegedly would make your chances amazing, forgetting the reality that this is down to sperm, eggs, embryos being put into a healthy environment. Fundamentally, I believe the patient should make the decision. So my job is to inform and educate. I will support anyone with what they want to do, as long as they're appropriately informed.